Hello coach, welcome to the post-match conference. I have a few questions for you from media. The first one is from the bridge. Was it poetic justice the way you got the goal?
Well, it was poetic justice. It's nice that, you know, the linesman's in a good place to, obviously the ball's over the line. But it's not poetic justice because we lost 3 points the other night. I mean, this team keep giving us everything we've got. We should actually, with what's happened to Jamshedpur FC, we should actually be at the top of the table, given the points that have been taken from us through unfortunate circumstances. But this group of players, they work so hard. I mean, players are taking painkilling injections to play because we're short of numbers with injuries, but they keep on giving me everything they've got in the field, and an absolute credit to work with. And we fully deserve the 3 points.
Coach, Welskis had not scored in the 3 games, yet your team has got 6 points. Does that silence those who label your side as over-dependent on Welskis?
Yeah, I think what's happened, in fairness, a lot of the teams we're now playing are double-marking Welskis, and that's creating opportunities for other people. But Welskis, I've told you before, he's such a wonderful striker. You know, Nerka doesn't have to score goals to contribute to the team. He brings us up the field, he flicks things on, he's just a fantastic player to have. I've loved working him from the first moment I met him at Chennai, and we continue to do that, and he's just a wonderful all-round player. It takes more than just goal scorers to be a very good striker.
Coach, next question is from Sports Star. Is this the most complete performance you have had this season?
No, I felt we were outstanding against FC Goa. We were against Mohun Bagan. We've had, you know, we, given what happened the other night, we should probably be 8 games unbeaten. We lost the first game of the season when, if truth be told, we probably weren't ready given the pre-season, all the injuries we had. But game by game, we've steadily improved. We stood 3 points the other night against FC Goa, and then we come out tonight against Bengaluru. A wonderful team. Listen, this is a very good team, Bengaluru, and they make you work hard. They've got a terrific coach, some very good players. But we stood up to everything, every question we were asked. But we were a real threat, and we had many chances. I think we scored one goal, we could have 2 or 3. I think they had 1 or 2 very good chances in the first half. I have to be fair and give balance to that, as we did. But we fully deserve the 3 points.
Coach, next question is from Deccan Herald. You spoke about Rehnej the last time as well, but has he been the best informed goalkeeper in the league?
Well, I can only speak about my goalkeeper, nobody else. There's some wonderful goalkeepers. There was an Indian international at the other end tonight. Guthrie had a fantastic save from our skipper in the second half and 1 or 2. So he's an outstanding keeper. But Rinesh, when I was bringing him to the club, I spoke to him beforehand. I told him how I like to play, what I would need from him. And I loved the chat we had. And on the back of that, then I was determined to sign him, which I did. But with a really good conversation, he's did everything I asked. There are still areas that we continue to talk about because I want him to keep improving, keep striving to get better. But he's a wonderful lad, and his performances are everything that we need from a goalkeeper.
Coach, next question is from ANI. Have you settled into your best 11?
No, because we don't. We have players, I have to say, that are giving me everything they possibly can. I've been delighted with their effort and their application. I still think there's room for improvement. There's some things tonight you probably heard me say that I wasn't particularly happy about. So that's things that we'll get better as we go and we work together. But we have David Grande missing, Nick Fitzgerald missing, Narendra Gallo missing. Joyner just came back in tonight, had to come in with the injuries we got. So this group of players, you know, they just keep giving you everything they've got. We've been hampered. We've only had 5 foreigners since the start of the season. We've not been able to even bring any into the game. So we know as we move forward, we're going to be a stronger team, I believe, in the second half of the season.
Last question, coach. You have a long break before your next game. How do you plan to utilise the time?
Well, again, I've got to say, it's a long break. But if you look at what's happened to Jamshedpur on the field, but even off the field, we've now been asked to play 9 games in something like 33 days. We've had the toughest run from any team in the league, bar none. Not even up for debate. And these players keep giving everything you've got. So I think, you know, people need to look at certainly the next set of fixtures. I wouldn't expect Jamshedpur to have to play the amount of games that we did in the first half, but that's the way it is. So hopefully we can use those days to try and get 1 or 2 injuries back. Hopefully the boys that picked up knocks tonight, God willing, that they'll be okay. Because I think we're starting to get the feeling of being a very competitive team and a decent team. And that's what we need to do to keep moving forward.
Thank you, coach, and good luck for the next game.
Pleasure as always. Thank you.